Does she give you the finger? No, she's holding a rose in her hand. Today we are at the Tudor Mansion near Eastbourne. We're definitely going to find ghosts here. Most certainly. Was built in 1229. And then one or the other must have died. What a bean soup. I couldn't think of any other soup. So, this is a herb cauldron. Oh shit. Herb soup tonight. No. Tonight we're having witch herb soup. So a soup after all? A witch's potion. Welcome to the Matrixers. As already announced, we are at the Tudor Mansion today. And we will move through the garden and the property and present you with a video. A theme of the Matrix. Yes, let yourself be surprised about the topic. Certainly some of you will be interested in this. And yes, while we are walking through the garden here, you can hear us chatting from time to time. Sometimes you see us too. We will take turns and it will be a different kind of video. Correct. Then you see both. You see the Tudor Mansion first. A beautiful, huge garden in England near Eastbourne, and at the same time we can then deal with an interesting topic. And today's topic is teleportation? Yes, due to some inquiries about which topic we could maybe deal with, the inspiration for teleportation came. I'd say let's go and start chatting, right? Yes, okay, and although teleportation is somehow something that has always fascinated us and we have already done a lot of research about it, and I had dreams about it too, and yes, we'll see. Yes, I think teleportation is a very exciting topic. I once had a dream with and from my higher self. And the dream was actually about it. There was war at the time. I was there with a group and we wanted to help. And that was all difficult, hardly possible, because we had to go to this place, which was relatively far away, about 3 or 4 kilometers. At that moment the higher self, a voice from the off and said and wanted to show me how teleporting works. Very exciting, because I became half lucid. Then I noticed everything exactly and felt that my consciousness was then practically split in two. I was the person who suddenly got the vibration frequency increased and also watched myself doing it. Yes, teleporting was really, it's a feeling, a certain feeling. The frequency of the body is increased and yes, I noticed that so far and then I woke up. What was your experience? Well, I've often dreamed of teleportation. I've also often used teleportation in lucid dreams. Or astral travel. Out of body experience. It's the standard way to get around. Yes, so that's right. But still, teleportation is more difficult in astral travel than in a lucid dream. When out of body experience, it can sometimes happen that you end up somewhere else than where you wanted to go. Or you suddenly wake up in bed and think, damn it, that's it with the out of body experience. So it has happened more than once. So you have to train first. I've practiced this more often in lucid dreams, usually only bit by bit, like 10, 20, 50,100 meters wide, in the hope that I could take this ability over to everyday life, but so far I haven't been able to. But I once had a very interesting dream. I was traveling with two people. We then went to the ledge and were able to look down into the valley from there and saw some people who had teleported there. And then one of the two people who was with me explained to me that they were collaborators from the Matrix manufacturers. Yes. And that they can enjoy privileges. And the privileges included being able to teleport. So they showed them how it works, resp. Maybe they gave them some kind of technological devices so they can teleport. And I found that very interesting. Yes, it is. Yes, teleportation has many advantages, so you can't move out of the Matrix with it. But what is possible is that you never have to lug around suitcases again. No more bus money or train tickets or plane tickets. Bye. You're there within seconds and don't have to sit on the plane for 12 hours. So it has many advantages. And for those of you with a slightly more flexible morale, you can use it to bind yourself to a vault and get gold out of it. Yes, actually the question is how could teleportation work, because it will work. And what exactly is teleportation? And yes, I mean, we've already discussed and talked about it a lot and actually it's just a change of realities. But basically we don't change the place or anything, but the place changes. Ah, that's right. I had that once during an out-of-body experience or that was don't remember. Exactly. Yes, in any case, the space around us is actually moving. So basically we don't move at all anyway. Basically, we're actually teleporting all the time, to be precise. Yes, but only the ego needs a justification. And that will probably be walking. We're moving now, and it's actually a teleportation with the justification about feet. Yes, the ego always needs a justification. The way here, everything is so wildly overgrown. On the streets, the trees are still allowed to grow in the streets, canopies. There are so many wild gardens. Well, in Germany and Austria everything is iron and groomed, but nature is still quite free here. Yes, the streets are all covered with trees. So you drive there constantly through such avenues of trees with a canopy of leaves. And because all the branches stick out over the road and nobody cuts them off. In Germany or Austria, they would have long since made sure that you crops and straightens, right? Just it. It's great that in England people don't try to keep nature under control as much as in Austria or Germany or Switzerland or the surrounding area. Even if you haven't seen that in Italy or Spain. Yes, teleporting with the physical body. We have also discussed this with other friends. What did Nadia think about that? For them, there were also ways of teleporting. I just saw it through the vibratory frequency, the elevation of the body. Yes. So, the possibility of teleporting is a question of whether it then works like a fax. You insert the document into one fax machine and it comes out of the other fax machine. Then you would actually have to exist twice and the original would then have to be destroyed. They would make a copy of us, which we will then send over. Yes, that would be a possibility. That would be the technical solution. Another possibility would be the doppelganger, right? But well, you only manifested a second self, so to speak. So that's not actually teleporting. Yes, the second possibility would be that you can use your double, that is, your astral body, and send it to another place, let's say to Egypt, and manifest it there so strongly that it is almost physical. Look, I found a dwarf chair for me. Looks more like an Anunnaki chair to me. Ha ha ha, I once dreamed of the Anunnaki, the King of Kings, to come back. He called himself the Old Matrix King. Game of Thrones. The Sow, the continuation of the epic adventure. To damn. Yes, so that's the second option. One lies in bed, detaches oneself from one's body, flies to Egypt with the astral body and condenses it there so tightly that it is like physical. And if you've got it right, you'll just notice the doppelganger anyway and you can be in two places at the same time, for the cracks among you. If it works really well, then you can walk around physically in your body and physically in Egypt at the same time. And pseudo-physical in Egypt. That would also be a possibility. A third possibility would be, of course, to change reality. That means there are all kinds of alternative realities. There is an alternative reality in which we are in Austria right now. And there is the reality now that we are in England. So if I were to instantly switch to the reality that I am in Austria, would I actually have teleported? Theoretically, yes. Relatively irrelevant. The only art would be that in the other reality one anchors oneself there or that you don't slip back again, as is actually always the case when you perceive alternative realities. You always slip back into the usual reality. I mean, there are techniques to practice teleporting. We did a lot of research. Yes. And by then we had already figured out one or the other technique. Anastasia also presented a technique for teleportation. Well, there are ways, but I don't think we've had the time to see if it works. It is unknown. Yes, you need discipline and patience. Like everything that precisely this typical English. Yes, the typical English. And I find that very, very attractive. This style with the Buntsandstein is actually more to be here in the South. Brick, red brick are more likely to be found. Yes. You can say that I've been to the North quite a few times, and it's also very magical. But I also these huge ships. We're going to have coffee now. Yes, after this strenuous work, let's enjoy a small snack in the cafe. Apple pie and coffee, tell the joke. Apple pie and from Apple Pay and Yes, two friends meet in a cafe and one says, "Hey, I'm going to London tomorrow and I can't speak a word of English. Can you maybe give me a tip what to order in a restaurant?" Then his friend says, "Yes, no problem. You just say apple pie and coffee." "Oh, that's great, I'll do that." And the friend drives to London and a week later he calls his friend who tipped him off and says, "Oh, I can't see apple pie and coffee anymore." Constant apple pie and cough. "Do you have any idea what else I could order?" And then he says, "Yes, just say ham and eggs." "Oh yes, that sounds good. I'll do it." He immediately runs to the nearest restaurant. The waiter comes and says, "Yes, sir." And he like this, ham. Does the waiter look at him and say, "With white bread or black bread?" A.
Ham and eggs.
White bread. With white.
Ham and eggs.
Ham and eggs.
Black bread.
White bread or black bread. Apple pie and coffee. Do you know the movie Jumper? He was pretty cool. When I saw it for the first time, I was really fascinated. So the ability to switching from one place to another was awesome. Yes, you saw that teleportation can also make you lazy. He teleported himself from the sofa to the fridge to get a beer. He was traveling with his friend and he was driving his car and he was also able to teleport. And he always teleported his car with me. But he could only do that 10, 20, 30 meters away. He has not yet figured out how to use it to cover greater distances. But as the film also shows, at some point some strange organization will notice that you can teleport. And then it can happen that somehow or somewhere you have a secret service on your heels that is trying to capture you or, yes, prevent you from teleporting any further. Because you're not allowed to do something like that. So teleportation, if you could do that, I bet it would be banned. Just like everything is forbidden everywhere. Yes, think about it. Nobody would use airplanes anymore. Buses, taxis, trains, car. Everything would no longer be necessary. That would almost be an economic collapse. I would say economic suicide. Yes. There are also techniques for people who want discipline and consistency. Maybe you would like to tell about Anastasia. Yes, there is the technique of Anastasia from Russia. There is a series of books said to have been written by this woman. And that also mentions teleportation. And so she suggests a technique in which you wash your dishes. For example, remember every single minimal step during washing. How to wash a plate. How to wash the cutlery. Which plate you took first. Whether you first took a fork or a spoon or a knife. So everything is registered very precisely, in every detail. And let's say it takes 20 minutes to wash the dishes. Then you should go to bed and then set the alarm clock. Exactly 20 minutes. And then you should try to imitate exactly what you did when doing the dishes. It has to look exactly like this. Every plate in the right order. Every fork. Every spoon. Every knife. Everything exactly in the exact order. You have to train it in such a way that it lasts exactly as long as you did it physically beforehand. and then just do it over and over again until you get it right. And that should have the effect that you ultimately teleport from your bedroom to the kitchen, for example, and then find yourself doing the dishes there. Okay, but with me, for example, when I was supposed to practice this in a dream, it was already very clear that one should try to increase the vibrational frequency of the body. So that was really a kind of state, a feeling state. I then practiced that the next day and I was able to get the feeling back up. And that has. I also felt the vibration. Of course, that was probably just the drop from the right up to the mark, but for me that was a feeling state of this. This increase in frequency, that you really make the body so light that you make it practically transparent and then transfer it somewhere through this vibrational state. So you mean here like this movie called Celestine. What was the name of it? I do not know. There's a movie about it. It's called Celestine. Oh yes, yes, yes. And in the film they increased their frequency so much that the soldiers who were chasing them suddenly became invisible. And the soldiers couldn't find them because they were so high in frequency that they were invisible to normal physical people. Yes, that's exactly how it was. I could see it and I experienced it. It became more and more high frequency. And this was. Should be the springboard, according to my higher self, to be able to teleport. Yes, you would then have to make sure that you let your molecules vibrate so high that you can transport them from one place to another in the body. The question is then also, do I need an exact geoposition later or do I have to imagine the place? I probably have to imagine something where I want to go then. Well, in the case of the dream it was at least like that, I had to know the place by then. Where I wanted to go, yes. Yes, exactly. The prophecy of Celestine, as the movie resp, the book. That was actually a New Age book, but teleportation wasn't a direct topic, it was mainly about increasing your energies, just so high that you enter another level of being, which is still physical, but in a higher frequency. Okay, yeah? Well, you'll probably have to dial the frequency back down then if you want to get physical again, if you. After teleporting. Yes, yes, that's clear. Otherwise nobody washes the dishes anymore. Or here in, X-Men, there was also someone who could teleport, this younger one. But he could only port himself as far as he could see. So he had to know the place. Could only always say, ah, there's the farthest point at the back and then he could teleport himself there. The question is also the space around you. I mean, you can just shift the focus, can't you? It's the reality that's around you, the space. If you were to change the room around you, that would also theoretically work. That means, if I'm sitting here in the meadow now and notice the tree in front of me and the house behind me and if I practically change the location in my mind, that would somehow be a possibility to teleport. So I change the space around me. Yes, that would be what I mentioned earlier with the alternate reality. Because every reality exists. That means there's a reality now that you are sitting over there. Yes, exactly. Or that we're sitting over there and not here. And that means you would just have to switch reality, from here to there. I mean, Carlos also described it in his book that he suddenly teleported, didn't he? Yes. How did he do it? Or is it even more? He did this through meditation. He always had a stick. He always put it on his knees and put his head on the stick and then just tried to stop the world. That's what he called it. Which for me is actually very much related to dissociation. That you reach a state in which the mind can no longer think. And when the mind can no longer think, then it can no longer repeat all its beliefs and think. I think that's the basic problem, that we think we can't do it. Doubt just kills everything that is possible. Well, you could start small, for example, and try what does it mean to start small. You could start vibrating your molecules so high, higher than physical reality, and then try to go through the wall. One could at least begin to increase one's vibration frequency with the command, increase the vibration frequency. That actually works. I did that a lot for a while and then the body actually vibrates and vibrates and vibrates and doesn't stop at all. And then you already feel that you somehow become lighter. But I'm not driven yet. But so easy. I mean, the matrix is the matrix, which means it's programmable. The body is part of it, so you can simply give commands to the body. The body has its own intelligence. And then when you say increase vibrational frequency, it actually works. Yes. Of course you have to focus, that's clear. Yes. Does it taste good? Good. Grass is very new. This is true. I've eaten dandelion salad for a long time. Also very good. But diet is another issue. A very exciting, very controversial. And we will make a video about that in the very near future. The sustenance and realities related to realities and all possible. Very, very exciting topic actually. We had a very long discussion about it. A very long conversation and we won't withhold it from you. Oh yeah. Absolutely. Weed wasn't on the list right now, but it... Yes. Nature has actually offered and still offers all people the opportunity for there to be an abundance of food for everyone, such as grass. You might not think so, but everything is in grass. There are many vitamins and many other substances that are important for the body. Simply in the grass, there are a dime a dozen. The chlorophyll in it is important, but we don't have a nutrition video right now, correct? Another time, a very exciting time. Well, what else do we have for teleportation? Oh, there was so much to tell. Oh yeah, teleportation is, yeah. There are also no workshops on teleportation. Not that I know, and I can already explain why. Yes, the one who would show it would be out of the window in an instant. Yes, so if you could do teleportation now and give a workshop and show the others how it's done. I don't know how long it will be before the CIA or anyone else is on the mat and wants to know how this was accomplished. So I'm sure there are people in this world who can do that. It probably won't be the crowd, but I think so, only they won't peddle it. Yes, it is. We probably don't either. Nah, nay wouldn't make any sense. So no matter what you can do and what your skills are, you wouldn't overdo it. Not in this matrix. If I could teleport, I think I'd keep it to myself. Son is correct. He could do that. He could also teleport based on some reports. Well, some traders met with them because Saint-Germain always had jewels with him, which he always paid with or had converted into money, and he also met with traders from time to time. And so some traders described that after the trade or the conversation was over, the Saint-Germain would have said goodbye, would have gone about 50 meters away and would then have disappeared without a trace. Yes, that's right. By the way, I was in India once, in this cave of this one guru, who also had his... He was in this cave and suddenly he was too. He did have an interview with a reporter, but at the same time he was spotted in a pharmacy somewhere in town. What was his name just? Not Sananda. Sai Baba. And his cave was really very very crass and exciting horny energy. Mega violent. You immediately have the feeling that you are in love with the whole world and much more. So very crass energy. I don't think I've ever experienced anything like that. And it was also said of him. At least he must have sent his doppelganger or something like that. Yes, yes, it was a reporter who had planned an interview with Sai Baba and then met him in a room and the reporter looked for his films and they were gone. And then he said, "Oh God, I forgot the films in the hotel and now I would have to drive back and it will definitely be a few hours before I would be here again." And then he said, Baba said, "Wait a minute, what kind of films are these?" And then he told him exactly what the films were called. And then the Sai Baba closed his eyes for a moment and when he opened them again, he reached under his kaftan and pulled out two films. So honestly, I can really imagine that being true because of the energies that I felt there. Shit man, yes, very, very honestly. Yes, that was in Abu XXX, it was, the caves, in India, TXXX just for info, by the way, yes, and the reporter said he couldn't get it out of his head. Where did the Sai Baba get the movies from? And then went to the store. He had told him which shop had these films, and then he was home. When he was home again he went to this Photoshop and then showed a picture of Sai Baba and then said, "This is it man, been here before?" And they said, "Yes, yes, we noticed him because of his hair and his looks. He looks so Indian and so we talked about it for a long time. He bought two films here." And then he asked, "Yes, when?" And that's exactly where he reached under his robe and pulled out the films. So he must have been in the Photoshop at the same moment. Oh, awesome. That means he wasn't actually away from the photographer at all. He just suddenly reached into his robe. Yes, cool. For the photographer, the Sai Baba sat there all the time. Meg, yes, yes, yeah, and that's where I think he used the doppelganger technique. That sounds a lot like it. Yes, I've been too. With Ram Dass at a workshop in America and quite by accident, with 400 participants, the only German was sitting next to me, a very sweet old lady and she said she also does a lot with her doppelganger. And she also said that she would come visit me and that I should provide a mirror because she wanted to come through the mirror with her doppelganger. I don't know if she will ever do that because she was a very, very, very old lady. Yes, I think the Sai Baba did what I mentioned before, that he just sent his double. He manifested the doppelganger there, bought the films there and returned with the doppelganger and was therefore able to take the films with him. And that's what makes it so exciting, because it's a bit reminiscent of teleportation with the feature that you can also take objects with you. Yes, perfect. Packing your suitcase is then no longer necessary. And then you can look at the pyramids in Egypt and when you're done, you beam yourself home. You don't need a hotel anymore and you can then sleep at home, and the next day you beam yourself back to Egypt, etc. It's cool to sleep somewhere other than at home. Yes. But the possibility is definitely there. Yes. Yes. Another technique would probably be to learn about dissociation using teleportation. Yes, definitely. Hmm. Do we have anything else on teleportation? Oh, we've talked about this so much, man. What was all that? Yes. There are many, many stories about teleportation. A lot of possibilities. A lot of techniques. Well, actually not that many techniques. So there are hardly any techniques, but there are at least many current reports from normal natural science. They're trying to teleport quantum particles all the time. I think they've already done that. I think it was the Japanese or the Chinese who beamed some particles into space or something, and of course see that as a minimal advance on teleporter technology. Just like you know them from Star Trek. Yes. Yeah, and yes, and that could of course become attractive if it is invented at some point, at least on a technical level, or I think yes, it's been there for a long time. Yeah, sure. Nobody tells us that. there is this pictorial joke. You see a man sitting at his desk and writing with a ballpoint pen. In the 1940s, and then writes, yes, I am writing you the letter with a ballpoint pen, which was not invented until after the war. Understand? It's clear. So that these technologies already exist. Yeah, sure. And that, as I said, from an economic point of view, I don't think teleportation would be exactly suitable for triggering an economic boom. But you know, the technical side wouldn't appeal to me that much, although it would be super cool. But I don't always want to have my ear on my foot or my toe on my nose or something. I think I'd rather be able to do it myself. But what came to mind? Portals. Surely you could use portal. Maybe someone knows the game Guild Wars. Portals are also used there, where you can beam yourself from one place to another. Yes, there are very, very many portals, dimensional portals. I've had dreams about that too. Yes, yes, me too. Recently, through a tunnel, and then I was suddenly so super horny somewhere in space with lots of spaceships and stuff like that. Freaky. Yes, as I said, portals. And there are also portals on Earth from place to place. Just like in the game. There are also possibilities that you can use portals. So I could well imagine that nature provides such portals. You just have to be able to see them. That is, if you then have the eye for it, then you can see such a portal, go there, put yourself in a certain state, and this portal then transports you to another portal. Yes, look, in my old house, there was a portal within this world. And this portal led to a cafe. You discovered it once. At some point you said that some woman came out or something who was very confused. Yes, yes, the portal was in the middle of, and then sometimes at night I heard voices. Yes, and that always seemed to me like a cafe or a train station or something like that. It might have been a portal, but I didn't know how to use it either. But as I said, nature offers everything, and why not teleportation too? Okay, before you have eaten the meadow empty, we want to call it quits. No, there's still a lot of even. There's so much grass here. So much weed. Okay. Yes, actually, I always found it exciting. We used to talk a lot about all these states of consciousness for teleporting. Not only about a change of reality, but also, what was it then? But it was so cool. It was totally exciting. Yes, about focus. Yes, well, dissociation would of course be a possibility. Another possibility for teleportation. You really have to switch off your thoughts completely so that you can switch off that doubter in your head that says, that's not possible, or I don't know how it's supposed to work, or something like that is impossible, or I can't do it, I'm not good. Enough for that or anything like that. And what's more, during dissociation, an enormous amount of energy is stored. You can feel that too. If you dissociate a lot, then the body starts to vibrate, and it's a vibration similar to that from the dream, where my vibration frequency increased to start teleportation. So I can well imagine that this can really be a technique for teleporting. Yes, in any case. Ah, cool, look. You have to see that. The whole duck family is running around back there. Wait, there she is. Yes, I think. Then, I would say, I think the video is really, really long anyway. And yes, I hope you enjoyed it and we've given you a few suggestions that you might want to think about for yourself. Maybe you also have ideas on how to learn to teleport. Yeah. Yes, as always, we look forward to your comments and we wish you a nice time. Until the next video. Bye.